Hey, what's going on everyone, and welcome to a new video. So this is a video that I'm very excited to film today. This is about a product that I've been anxiously awaiting for especially the last couple of months since pre-orders went live, but really, I mean, I've been had a very strong interest since the product was announced back, I think, I don't remember when this was. I think it was either earlier this year or sometime late last year. That is, we're going to be unboxing a new game console today. So yes, this is what we're going to be having a look at today. So this is a package from EB Games, which is the retailer whom I pre-ordered this from. This is an Xbox Series X. I decided to buy one of these because, well, I do have an Xbox One, and over the previous console generation, the 8th generation, despite the Xbox One's flaws, it has been my preferred platform, mainly because I prefer the way the Xbox works compared to the PS4, and I vastly prefer the controller, as well as the types of games that the Xbox has are more to my taste, stuff like Forza and Halo. And Gears of War. You may be thinking to yourself though, but the Xbox doesn't have any games! Yeah, it does. That may be true. It doesn't have any launch titles that are quote, next generation. What Microsoft is trying to do with this console is that they're basically just evolving the Xbox One, or the Xbox One X, really, in a way. Now, I never bought an Xbox One X, so I actually stayed with the original VCR model. And I've had that for the last 5 years or so. I got mine in 2015, before the One S came out. And I've enjoyed it quite a bit. Performance on some games hasn't been the greatest. Overall, I do like it. But yeah, with the current launch, I mean, this console was supposed to launch with Halo Infinite. And the issue happened, I guess, mostly because of the current pandemic, the current situation. A lot of people are working from home, and a lot of people are working, you know, remotely, and it's short-staffed and whatnot. And Halo's development was already kind of a mess, and so that's why, even though Halo was supposed to launch with this thing, they didn't actually launch it. They actually, I believe it's coming sometime next year. Hopefully it comes in the first half of next year, because I actually am kind of eager to get into Halo Infinite. It's been quite a while since it was a good Halo game, at least, because I don't consider Halo 5 a good Halo game. But yeah, let's go ahead and stop talking and let's get this unboxed. Now, I decided to film this while still in the shipping box because just to show that it is brand new and that this is my pre-order, because if you've been reading the news, the gaming news lately, there's been scalpers as well as there's been people stealing these things. Now, I've blanked up my address, of course, to you know, so that people don't fucking find out where I live and come and rape me in my sleep. But this is my pre-order. I pre-ordered this on the day they went live. It was a pain in the ass. My pre-order process, it was hilarious. So I live in Victoria in Australia, which is on the East Coast. And so I live in the Eastern time zone. And so the pre-orders went live, I believe, went live in my area around 8 in the morning on, forget what day it was in September. And so I was on my way to work. I think I had a 9 a.m. shift that day. And so I literally had my iPad with me, and I got on the train, and which my train was, I got on the train about 10 to 8, that's where the train, because I have to get a train to work. I work about 40 k's out from where I live. And so pre-ordering this thing was hilarious. I had a friend of mine also pre-ordering one as well, and we were literally both, they were at home, and I was on my way to work on the train. So I was this one weird fuck on the train, sitting there with an iPad Pro, just spamming the refresh button on the screen, and just, I probably looked like a complete idiot, just tethered to my hotspot, trying to pre-order this thing. And then I had to get off the train, right? I literally was walking down the street towards the supermarket, because on my way to work, my routine is I get on the train, go to the town I work in, and then get off, go to the supermarket, grab stuff like, you know, like a drink, for example, or, you know, snacks for the day, basically, because fuck paying the outrageous prices at the vending machines in my work, so I just get them from the supermarket in the morning. literally on my way, I was just walking down the street holding this fucking iPad, just refreshing the fucking page. Even while I'm in the supermarket, I was doing it. I probably look completely weird. But it ended up being a waste of time because the page ended up going down right as I exited Woolworths and was about to start heading on to work. And so that's when the page went down. This is about 8:30. So the pre-order page was only live for about half an hour. It was slow the entire time. So are you thinking, how did you pre-order one if you didn't actually get one in when the pre-orders were live? See, here's my genius. This is my accidental genius. My desktop computer right behind me. I had the pre-order page open the night before because I was checking it out to see when it went live because I wanted to make sure that I would be awake when the pre-orders went live. And so I left the pre-order page open and I minimized the page and because it was in its own separate window. And so I minimized the Chrome window and then just put my computer to sleep and went to bed the night before. And I completely forgot it was there because in the morning when I went to wake up to go to work, I didn't turn on my computer. I just got up, had a shower, had breakfast, and got ready for work and then left. And so when I got home, I was in a little bit of a mood because my job kind of sucks. I think that day wasn't the greatest. And I was especially annoyed because I didn't get the pre-order in. I knew it wasn't the end of the world. I wasn't raging or whatever. I knew it wasn't the end of the world, but I knew scalpers had really pretty much gotten to them as well as it was just generally high demand for these things. And so my genius is this: when I get home, literally I open the page, I open my minimized windows, and lo and behold, there's the pre-order page that hadn't refreshed. And so what I did is I literally clicked add to cart and it added it to my cart, and then I actually could check out. And the only reason I could check out is because this page was sitting on my computer since the night before, and it let me check out only because this was at 6 p.m. that night. There was no one accessing the site at that time. So my pre-order worked, and it went through, and here it is. That was my blindest bit of luck. The only bit of luck in my life I will ever have is pre-ordering the Series X. This is going to be a story I will tell any potential grandchildren, okay? So I am going to... I couldn't make this up if I tried, So let's go ahead and open up this box. We're going to use our traditional screwdriver here. Speaking of Xbox here, a lot of you may remember back in 2015 when I got my Xbox One. That turns out to have been my most popular video I have ever made. That video I uploaded in October of 2015, and it just kept getting views and views and views. It was getting into the hundreds of thousands. Now, I do have a few videos in the hundreds of thousands. My second most popular video is around about 300, maybe 400,000 views. But this Xbox One video just kept climbing. It was by the end of 2015, by Christmas of 2015, it was already I think it was 150,000 views already at that point. Then the next year, Christmas 2016, even after the Xbox One S came out, people were still searching for Xbox One. And so I've come to the conclusion, the reason why that video became the most popular on my channel is because if you do a search term of Xbox One, 1 terabyte, my video is the first in the list. I looked at the analytics for that video, and most of the traffic comes from search results. So either Google or YouTube, they combine them. They don't separate Google search or YouTube search. Yeah, that video had become my most popular video. In fact, probably there's probably a fair few subscribers that subscribe because of that video. And I just want to say to everyone who has watched that video, even if you're coming from this video, from that video to this one, because I reckon YouTube's algorithm will probably suggest this to you if you have watched my Xbox One video from 5 years ago, I just want to say thank you. I just want to say thank you to everyone who has, you know, watched my videos over the last few years, especially that Xbox One video. It hit over a million views I think it was a couple of months ago. And I'm eternally grateful for anyone who has watched this content. It was amazing to me that hit over a million views. I've never addressed this topic and in a video before. And so I just wanted to, say, you know, thank you to everyone who has been, who has watched that video and helped my channel grow, because my subscriber count literally doubled within the span of a year of that video. Alright, so let's get the Xbox out here. So, get rid of the shipping box. There we go. There it is. So we get to power our dreams. So, here is the box for the Series X. We get to power our dreams here, as you can see, with Master Chief. It's kind of ironic because Halo Infinite isn't even out yet. And this you could really tell that they wanted to market this thing with Halo Infinite, and they just couldn't. It's too bad. Because a lot of people are slamming the Series X, and the Series S as well. This has a little brother, the Series S, if you're not aware. A lot of people are slamming these because, oh, it's got no games! But, to be honest, the games that I want to play, I've been playing on an original VCR Xbox One. I want to play them in some decent fidelity for once, and yeah, I know, I do have a decent PC I could run the games on, but, you know, these days I generally, you know, I do like PC gaming, but it's just gotten to the point in my life where I'm a busy man. I work a 9-to-5 job, sometimes not even 9-to-5, I work an 8-hour shift job, rotating roster, which is a pain in the butt, and you know, I don't really have time to. I mean, yeah, PC gaming has gotten a lot easier over the last 10 years, but, or however long it's been. I just, you know, I do prefer playing on a console, just, you know, sticking the disc in and just, you know, enjoying it. As well as, you know, I'm into tech. I like, you know, new tech. So, yeah, here is the Xbox Series X. So you can see that's what the top of it looks like. It doesn't actually have green lights in there. That's just, it's a green paint job on the inside of the fan vents there, which kind of gives it a little bit of a flare of the original Xbox. Because the original Xbox, if you're aware, had the green jewel on the top of it. In fact, I can show you one. Here is an original Xbox, so you can see the green jewel. So this, it's kind of reminiscent of that. It reminds me, because the rest of it is black. And then you just have the green accent on the top. Well, here we go. We have the rest of it is black, green accent on the top, because technically it's supposed to be, you know, stowed up vertically. So what do we have here? We have, let's see, it says 4K 120fps. Yeah, as if I'm going to be doing that. My TV is still only 1080p. 1TB SSD, which it's part of the reason why these things are a little bit expensive. This is a PCI Express 4.0 SSD. This is newer than, this is even faster than what I've got in my PC. I have a Samsung 970 Evo Plus. So it's PCI Express 3.0. Decent SSD. But yeah, the Series X and the PS5 can wipe the floor with that. But PCI Express Gen 4 SSDs do exist in PCs. You just have to have AMD Ryzen 5000, I believe, to take. I think you have to have AMD Ryzen 3000 and whatever current AMD chipset. I think it's X570. Or B550 or something, whatever the latest chipset is from AMD. So Ryzen 3000 or 5000 and newer to take advantage of these things. Or maybe Threadripper as well. I think 3rd gen Ryzen or newer you have to have, because Intel doesn't support it yet. So there we are, you can see there's the inside. So it's actually, the way this is designed, you have two different motherboards. You have the main motherboard with the system on chip, which is the AMD. So this is actually based on AMD Zen 2 tech. So it is basically a Ryzen, it's an 8-core Ryzen, so 8-core 16-thread. Basically a newer version of what's in my desktop. I have a Ryzen 1700X in my desktop. This is essentially a Ryzen 3rd gen version of that. I think it's Ryzen, it's Zen 2, so yeah, it would be Ryzen 3rd gen. Paired with an AMD RDNA 2 graphics card, which is actually only just hit the market for PCs. So RDNA 2 is the Radeon RX 6000 series. This is a cut-down version of that on an APU. So it can do 4K 120 in most games, I suppose. Most games would be at 4K. 120 FPS, I'm not sure. I think, depending on the game, you may be able to have modes where you can choose between the two. So what's included? We have the console, USB cable, controller, and I can't read what that last one says. I'm guessing internet connection is required. So, there we go. I didn't buy any games, but, you know, there is no game. But yeah, we get to power our dreams. It's advertising. Game Pass on there as well. It's just, yeah. There we are, the Series X. So I can't wait to open this thing, because I've wanted this for a while. So on the sides of the box here, we do have two pull tabs. So let's go ahead and pull these tabs. So, There we go, just pull that. I'm going to take it entirely off because I want to preserve the box. Especially because this is a launch console, I plan on keeping this for a long time. So, you know, this reminds me of the Surface, the original Surface Pro packaging, or Surface RT packaging, had the similar pull tabs. I guess I know they're just plastic pull tabs, but do we have one more? Yes, we have two more on the bottom. So let's go ahead and pull these. So, let's go ahead. So, with the Xbox generation, so they're called, there's the Xbox Series X and the Xbox Series S. So the Series S is generally designed to replace the Xbox One S, or maybe the original Xbox One, as well. So it's sort of the lower end option. It's an all digital console, you have no disc drive. The big push with that though is that it's a Game Pass machine, essentially. Or the Series S is a good buy if you're on a budget, but you also want to have either Xbox Game Pass or your library is basically digital at this point. I am a physical copy guy. I prefer physical copies of games just because I like the collector aspect of it, as well as just having something physical in your hands. It's just something I prefer. These tabs are being a bit of a pain in the ass. There we are. All right, I think I've got them all off. Maybe I do have to take them off. I keep sticking back. There we are. Okay, there we go. And let's open her up. Okay, well, that was supposed to stay there. Really high quality foam. Damn, that's like some thick boy shit. Okay, so let's go ahead and power our dreams. So let's get this thing out of here. And this thing, wow, this is actually, whoa, this is dense, man. This is heavy. This is one beefy boy. Okay, so let's just put this down, this brick. Again, really good foam, and I know that's, you know, not a big deal, but if you're shipping these things, you know, like, shipping guys, you know, they're big, burly, and they're rough with shit. They throw stuff in the back of trucks. This is gonna protect it. You can probably use this as a helmet. What do we have here? So, let's have a look. So, this is just telling us how to activate. So we plug in the console, we download the Xbox app on our phone, and we can, that you can get the Xbox app with that QR code there. And this is just telling us how to put the batteries in the controller. So basically, if you don't know how to do this, you shouldn't be buying an Xbox. Let's go ahead and open this component up here. And let's have a look at, we have a power cord. I have an original Xbox One. This is a godsend because I hate that damn power brick. As well as we have an HDMI cable. Now this is actually important. You don't want to get rid of this cable and just use your existing one. This is a 4K, this is an HDMI 2.1 rated cable. So this will do your 4K 120 or even your 8K as well. It does support up to 8K output. So if you do have a nice TV, which I don't, you want to use this. And we have the controller, which I'm actually kind of excited to take a look at because I do like the Xbox One controller, but I have heard they changed this up a little bit and made it a little bit smaller. As you can tell, I've got giant man hands, so let's have a look and see if they've ruined it or not. I mean, it's not going to matter to me because I use an Elite controller anyway, so I'm probably not going to be using this thing, but I do want to check it out anyway and compare it to the original Xbox One controller. So, we have the controller here. As well as we have a couple of AA batteries. A lot of people give Microsoft some shit because they include AAs. I think that it's actually a good thing because it gives you more options. For example, if you don't have a rechargeable or your rechargeable's dead, you can just pop in some AAs and there you go, you're off to the races. Trying out the controller. Sticks feel the same. Wow, the D-pad's a lot clickier. Feels a bit sturdier than the original Xbox One controller. I like the texture of it. So, the difference between this and the original Xbox One controller, or the One S controller, is that it has these textured grips now. So it's kind of like, you can feel that if I scratch here. Doesn't do anything, but it's got a textured bat finish on it, if you can't tell on the camera. And it's also on the back of the triggers too, so. So it actually makes it easier to feel for where the triggers are, which is nice. I like that. Sticks feel the same. D-pad feels a little bit clickier, as well as you do have... a lot of people compare this to the Elite controller. I'm going to debunk this and grab my Elite controller and show you, because it's actually quite... It looks It looks different and it's not the same. So let me just grab my Elite controller, and I use the regular D-pad, but I want to show the disc D-pad. So here is the disc D-pad. Let me swap it over. I don't like it at all, so that's why I use the regular one. So the disc D-pad on the Elite, and I believe the Elite, this is an Elite Series 1. As you can tell, mine's kind of falling apart. I'm actually getting an Elite Series 2 on the weekend. I meant to order one this week so I could have it when I got the console. Unfortunately, they won't deliver it to me. So I have to go in store and pick it in person. Real nice during COVID, but okay. Luckily for me, there's actually, in my area where I live, there's not really a whole lot of COVID anymore, which is great. But you can tell with the Elite control, you see they look similar, but they feel absolutely different. So yeah, they do not feel the same. The up, down, left, and right is more raised than the corners there. So even though it looks like the disc D-pad, it is not. Because when you look at the disc D-pad, this is all flat. Whereas this is not. This is, you can feel the up, down, left, right. And it's a lot clickier too than... Let me put the regular D-pad back on the Elite. I can't compare this to an Elite. I should get an original Xbox One controller. So here is the controller that came with my original Xbox One. So here is the Series X controller. You can see some cosmetic differences. So you can see where the Xbox button is. On the original controller, the plastic was molded this way, and it was in a glossy plastic. Whereas on the Series S, and whereas on a new Xbox controller, it's just flat here. And the Xbox logo is actually black, instead of being a chrome finish on this. The Elite controller also has the chrome finish as well. This is, you can see the Elite Series 1 is designed after the original Xbox One. I believe the Elite Series 2 is more of an Xbox One S and One X style, the second generation Xbox One controller. Other than that, I'm trying to feel if there's any difference. I don't hate it. I prefer the triggers. Now this is one, and the bumpers. This is one area I believe that no one's actually really pointed out. These are a matte finish now. On the old controllers that were glossy, this was disgusting because these would grease up. These would grease up. They feel slippery. But this combined with, it has a little texture on it, but it's also matte. The entire controller is a matte finish now. So the top doesn't actually get all greasy like these older Xbox One controllers did. The Elite doesn't have that issue. It's not glossy. It's more of a it's a silver satin finish. Playing around with, so yeah, sticks feel the same. Let's see. Try to feel the shape. People said the shape's different. It looks a little different. Bumpers are smaller, actually. Don't know if you can tell. But the bumpers have a different shape. It doesn't. It's very subtle, but in the hand it feels different. So the bumpers on the Xbox One feel like they're taller, whereas on the Series X they're like shorter and they're narrower. And as for width, are they the same? No, the Xbox One had wider buttons. Actually, they're like the from the edge to the center. They're wider than the ones on the Series S and Series X. So, yeah, there are smaller bumper buttons. Triggers are also a little bit smaller as well. Yeah, so that's why I get what they mean. The shape, the handles, the handles feel kind of the same. Yeah, this is bigger. Yeah, this feels smaller. It's not bad, especially with my man hands. It's not horrible. I definitely, compared to my Elite. Yeah, I prefer, I'm going to continue using my Elite, although I mean, I am getting an Elite Series 2, because this one's, not because this is bad, this is just wearing out, and mine's out of warranty, I can't get it fixed from Microsoft, so. But I don't hate it, yeah. As you can see, other things they've added, they have a share button now, so instead of just pressing Xbox and Y or Xbox and X to take a screenshot or record, you just press the share button, and there you go, you can share your clips. That nobody watches. Also, the best thing since sliced bread, USB Type-C, finally. This is actually another reason why I want the Elite Series 2, because mine has micro USB. So does the original controller, you can see micro USB. I hate micro USB. I hated it when it was new. I've hated it even more ever since ever since USB Type-C. I wish micro USB would die in a fire, and now my Xbox controller finally doesn't have micro USB, so I can finally replace it. Same with the PS5, that is also USB Type-C. So there we are, that's where the batteries go. I wonder if the same battery packs work. I think they do. So let me just pull the battery pack out of my Elite. And stick it in the Series. Yep, there we go. Battery packs from the Xbox One work right in the Series X and Series S controllers. One thing they should do is they should include the battery pack in the box instead of the AA's. That would be a better option, I reckon. And just keep AA's as an option for people who want it, rather than shipping it with AA's. I guess it's more cost-cutting to use AA's. At least they're Duracells, though. So that's not bad. They give you Duracells, so they're decent batteries. Although, the ones for my Xbox One that I bought 5 years ago are still in the box. I never opened them. So they're probably... I should probably take them out. I forgot to mention we also have a little quick start warranty guide here, so you can ignore that because, yeah, all you do is just plug it in and turn the fucking thing on. Okay, let's go ahead and power our dreams. So I'm gonna just take this little slip off here. And let me tell you, this thing is one heavy thick boy. It is pretty, it's dense. You don't think, like, a lot of people say, oh, it's heavier than it looks. No, this actually does weigh a fair bit. It's pretty heavy. So, if you're worried about this is, if you worry about it, like, falling off your media center or whatever, don't, because it's not. This thing has got some weight to it. Let's open that up. Open that. It's like a kid on Christmas. Except it's, November. It's almost Christmas. I was looking at Christmas gifts for people today. And here is Series X, and wow, I can't believe I'm finally... So I have not seen this in person yet. This is nice. Yeah. That is nice. Alright, let me get this plastic off. Get rid of that. Wow. It's smoother than I thought. Now, I've actually never had a 1X. So apparently this is the same material as the 1X. I've never owned one, so I've never really touched one in person. But yeah, we have Xbox button. Real power button this time. My original Xbox One is a stupid touch button, and I hate it. Because my Xbox One sits on my desk. Even brushing something against it, like a piece of paper or something, turns the thing on. It's so annoying. So we have the Xbox power button, we have the disk drive eject, so we do have a disk drive on this one. So the two Xboxes, I was getting into it before, but you have two models. We have the Series S and the Series X. So Series S is the lower end model. Now if you're on a budget and you don't care about having physical media, the Xbox One S isn't a bad the Xbox Series S isn't a bad option. So it's a Game Pass machine, basically. I think that's the reason Microsoft sort of built it, was to sort of push Game Pass more, because it's a digital only, you have no disc drive. If you care about physical games, you do have to get a Series X. Now, the Series X, on the other hand, is the high-end console. So the Series S is akin to the Xbox One S. The Xbox Series X is akin to the Xbox One X, but just next generation. So this, you do have an optical drive, a 4K Blu-ray, so you can use your physical media. You can also download games, of course. It does everything the Series S does, but more. So you do have a physical disc drive, so you can use a physical games. You also get 4K, you can do 8K output, and most games, pretty much all games will run at 4K. If not, you can scale them back. And it definitely will do 1080. You can do either... most games, you probably could do 4K on pretty much everything. 120 FPS, you could probably either do 4K 120 or scale it... 4K 60 or scale it down to 1440p or 1080p 120. And if you have a TV that's 4K 120 capable, some games will support it. I don't think everything does, at least not now, but you can. I only have a 1080p TV, so this is probably the only Xbox Series X showcase you're going to be seeing that is on a 1080p set. So yeah, and the front's pretty barren. You just have a USB 3.1 port and a sync button for the controller. You have an Xbox logo here, which I didn't even know was there, actually, until just now. Here's the top where the vent is. This is your fan. So you can see the green. That's not a light. You can see on the inside, if I zoom my camera in. So you can see on the inside there, it's just painted on the inner rim of the fan, and it gets brighter as you get closer to the center. So on an angle, it's supposed to look like a green LED. Now, I wish they had done a green LED, but I do like the green accent. It sort of gives this otherwise bland box kind of a little bit of flair. It's nice. In all the advertising, it's actually designed to stand up like this. But you do have four little rubber feet on the bottom, and so you can actually lie it down on its side as well. On this side, on the other side, the bottom, you do have a stand. Now, this does not come off, and don't try, because even if you do take it off, because it does technically come off if you take the console apart, there's actually no holes underneath it, so you may as well just leave it on there. Looks a bit silly if it's sitting like that, but really, who cares? And on the back, we have more ventilation as well as your ports. So you have your power in, gigabit Ethernet. There is the storage slots. So these, you cannot use next generation games on an external hard drive. You have to either store it internally or on the storage expansion. Now, you can store for safekeeping on an external USB drive, whether it's a mechanical drive or an external SSD. You just cannot play the games from the USB drive. So you have to play, in order to play any next generation games, you have to either use the expansion slot or the internal storage. Hopefully they come out with a 2 terabyte version of the console at some point, or a 2 terabyte. There's definitely going to be a 2 terabyte expansion at some point, I reckon. We're only up to 1 terabyte at the moment. When they come out with the 2 terabyte ones, I'm probably going to buy one. I'm not going to buy one now when they're only 1 terabyte, because it's a bit too much money to me to justify for only 1 terabyte of storage. I'll do fine with the internal storage for now. Anything that's backwards compatible, so Xbox One games and anything that, so Xbox One, Xbox 360, and original Xbox games that are compatible will run off a USB 3.0 drive. Even a mechanical one, which is actually where all my Xbox One games are stored, on an external drive. And I did that so when I got this, I could just plug it straight in, and it would work. However, any Series X games, anything that's designed for the next generation systems, for Series X and Series S specifically, has to run on the internal storage or the storage expansion, because it needs the throughput of the PCI Express 4.0. What you're not seeing here is a Kinect port, because Kinect is dead. I mean, there was no Kinect port on the Xbox One X and One S either, but you could use a USB adapter. On this, you cannot. But other than that, you just have some ventilation down here, so it doesn't really matter what orientation you have the console in. If you have it standing up, the foot, you can use this vent here, and it will suck in air from the bottom and exhaust out the top. If you have it lying down, it can intake from the back and either exhaust out the top or out the back here. If you're stupid and put something on the top of this, which, why would you? Because it actually is concave, it's not a flat surface, it's concave. If you put something on top of it and try and block the fan, it still has some ventilation through this gap here, as well as these back vents for intakes. But that's really the hardware. So here it is paired with the controller. This is what you've seen in all the marketing materials. So, let's go ahead and take out my old Xbox One, and let's go power our dreams. So here we have the Series X. Let's compare it to, well, the predecessor, the Xbox One. Now, I do not have an Xbox One S or a Xbox One X to compare it to, which are direct predecessors to this. because this is more of an evolution of the Xbox One X. But I've been gaming on this thing, at least for my primary console gaming, on the Xbox One, so the base Xbox One. I bought this one in 2015. May notice it looks a little bit different than other Xbox Ones. It's a 1 terabyte version. They actually changed to a matte plastic on the top. But other than that, it's a base Xbox One. You can see, though, the size difference. So you can see this one's taller, but the base Xbox One is a lot bigger. As well as the base Xbox One also has a power brick down there. So yeah, that's what this is, replacing this. So, because I do keep other consoles, like I do have an Xbox 360, and I have an original Xbox. Even though there are backwards compatible with Xbox 360 and original Xbox games on both of these, actually, it's not 100% backwards compatibility, so I like to keep the original hardware around. But I may try some backwards compatible games to see how they run on the Series X compared to my Xbox One. In terms of the feel of the hardware, though, the original Xbox One actually feels quite a bit chintzier and cheaper than the Series X. Like, you knock on this, sounds solid. On this, it's hollow. That's because this console actually is hollow, and I feel they've used a cheaper grade of plastic on the original Xbox One as well. You can feel seams everywhere of the different types of plastic. Like, you can feel the seams between the top plastic and the side strakes here, and the front piece all feels separate and then a glossy. Whereas this all feels molded out of the One. Now, I'm sure there are separate pieces, like this top vent here is separate, and so is the bottom and the back panel. But the rest of the frame, the rest of the body feels like the one piece of molded plastic. And it's a very soft touch, a very smooth feeling plastic as well, whereas this feels kind of rough. Also, one thing I absolutely love is hardware power button. Not this mess, the touch button. Anything will turn this thing on, it's so annoying. Let's just turn this stupid thing off. So let's go ahead and move this thing out of the way and plug in the Series X. There we go, there's the Series X hooked up where my Xbox One used to be. Except I haven't connected this cable. This cable is actually to connect my controllers. I had this connected to the side USB port on the Xbox One, but it looks kind of silly just sticking out the front like that, so I'm gonna have to possibly remove something from the back or get a USB hub, because I actually have an Xbox One TV tuner, which I never use, so I'm probably gonna get rid of that out of this setup. But because I need my external hard drive there, which has my Xbox One games installed, because I transferred them all to the external drive so I could plug it straight in when I got my Series X. So now let's go ahead and turn the TV on. Yeah, I'm gonna have to move this. I'm thinking of changing the order of this, moving this under the TV and putting the PS4 in that place, at least temporarily until I get a PS5. I do plan on getting a PS5, by the way, for those wondering, just not immediately. Even though the PS5 does have some good exclusive games, like, the new Dark Souls and the Spider-Man Miles Morales, I couldn't care less about either one of those. Yeah, I'm waiting for Gran Turismo 7 to come out, and then once that comes out, I'm probably gonna get one, so. But for now, I wanted to just upgrade my Xbox experience, because it's the primary system I've been playing lately, so. There we go. So we need to be on HDMI 1, which, are we? I don't know. Yes, we are. Okay, let's go ahead and power on the console. Well, that's a new sound. Way more dramatic intro. I like that. So I'm gonna have to get a controller ready. So this is the first boot, so let's go ahead and get the console set up. I'm going to be pairing it with my Elite controller, because that is the controller I will be using until actually Saturday, because that's when I'm gonna have to that's when I'm gonna get my Elite Series 2 is on the weekend, because they couldn't deliver it to me. Bastards. Okay, so it's asking me to set up my Xbox with my phone. So let's do that, actually, because I've never actually done this. So let's pull out the phone. Okay, so it says to use the Xbox app. So I do have the Xbox app installed on my iPhone here. So let's go ahead and launch that. Uh, And let's see what we have to do here. So it says my code. Okay. So let's get you set up. Next. Have a new console. Yes. So it's, yep. So get the console. So it says enter the code from the TV. That's what it says. Continue. Yes. Yeah, okay. There we are, connected. Yay. Next. Okay, so what we want to do is select the language. I'm not in the United Kingdom, but I am in Australia, so choose English Australia. So the setup is pretty much from the phone at this point, so let's readjust the camera so I don't have to hold it up like an idiot. Okay, so I actually have a stand on my phone, so I can just wipe it down like that. So English Australia, and we are in Australia, so click next. So it says let's do an update, so next. And now, as you can see, the console is now updating. What power mode do we want? So we can either do battery saving, or we can do instant on. Not battery saving, energy saving, sorry. So I'm going to do energy saving for now. Click next, because that's what I had on my Xbox One. I'll experiment with it later. I didn't like the way the original Xbox One did the instant on, because it kept the power brick on all the time. And that caused a couple of problems. One, the power brick has its own fan, so it was really loud. And the second, I could hear coil whine from it too. So, yeah, that was weird. But this new Xbox, it's silent. Yeah, there's definitely air coming out of the side there, though. Sign-in and security, we don't need any barriers. I'm the only one that uses this thing. So next, do you want to be automatically signed in? Yes, I do. Okay, automatic updates. No, I don't want automatic updates. I like to manage it myself. Next, turn on remote features. So what do we have here? Let me just zoom in so I can read. It says, when remote features are turned on, your phone can communicate with your console anytime you want. So I can install new games remotely to my console. Heck yeah. Use Xbox Remote Play to play your console games on your phone. That's pretty cool, although I'm using an iPhone, so, actually, no, that's only xCloud that's banned on iOS. Yeah, I should be able to play, Remote Play on my Xbox, on my, phone if I want. Although, I'd have to pair an Xbox controller to my phone, and that's a bit silly. Although you can, actually, the new controller does have Bluetooth compared to these old ones. So that would be a good thing to keep in my travel bag, maybe. Turn on and control your console with the phone. There reminded me, I'm guessing that's the old smart glass functionality that was part of the Xbox 360 and the early Xbox One. So let's turn that stuff on. Yep, enable. Oh, you have to have instant on to do that? Okay, whatever. Now let's sign in. Let's get started with my Xbox profile. Okay, next. I already have an Xbox profile, so I don't really want to edit any of that. And now it's just saying how we use your data. Basically, it just says we collect, recognize, diagnostic, and other data necessary to keep your console safe, secure, up to date. Basically, just hashtag data mining, so whatever, you can't do dick shit about that. Help make the Xbox experience better? No. Give my console a name, so I'm going to name it. Jax. Series... X, because my other one's just Jack's Xbox One, so at some point I'm thinking of maybe putting my Xbox One either in another room, or possibly, I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it yet. It's not really worth a whole lot to sell, because no one really wants one of the old VCR Xbox Ones. It says, want to keep in touch, so what's this, so, oh, that's for email and stuff, so, not now. I didn't think for a setup screen I'd be staring at a phone all day, but I guess most people look. Back in 2013 it was different, not everyone had a smartphone. A lot of people did, I did, but not necessarily everyone. But these days, everyone has one of these things, and honestly a lot of people don't even upgrade their smartphones all the time. My phone's 3 years old, and I don't really care. All done, so just exit that, and there we go. That's probably what I was last playing, was Red Dead 2. So that's the setup portion, at least from the phone, so I just have to wait until the console finishes updating and see what happens from there. Oh, now it's my phone's actually come up with the Microsoft Authenticator, so let's go ahead and just do that real quick. It's probably wanting me to sign in, so let's have a look. New sign in detected. Okay, so there we go. Now it's authenticated me, so let me just close out of that, and let's go ahead and press Xbox on my controller. So, we're going to use my Elite Actually, you know what? I'm going to take the battery out of my Elite. I'm going to pair it with my suit and the new one. I want to try the new one out for a bit. So, and I kind of want to retire this Elite because, yeah, the grips. I don't know if I can get this repaired by a third party. I can't do it officially, though, because it's out of warranty. Let's try the new controller. This is the Series X controller, so we're going to try this out for a bit. Just put in my battery pack. So I don't want to use the double A's. And press Xbox. Will it pair automatically? Maybe not. Maybe I have to sync it. Alright, so, and press the sync button on here. I think that'd be paired from the factory, but I guess not. Yep, now it's paired. Cool. Okay. And press A. Yep, let's update my controller. So I have to do an update on the controller. I wonder if these ones can update wirelessly. The old ones you couldn't. You had to plug them in. Update. So now the controller's going to update, and this will just flash. Yeah, we're living in the age where even your game controller needs updates. Although the Xbox One controller did the same thing. So these ones don't take very long. I tell you what, though, I do like these textured things. Not as much as I like the rubberized grips on my Elite. I like these more. And I like the weight of the Elite a lot more. That's why I prefer it, because I prefer... The reasons why I prefer the Elite is because it has shorter button throws. You have the hair trigger locks, which I actually do use. I do use these hair trigger locks in shooters. Because in racing games, you want to have the full trigger action. But in shooters, you want to flick that down, and then you have the hair trigger locks, which are good for shooters like Halo and Call of Duty and whatnot. But yeah, I generally prefer the shorter travel for the face buttons. Just the overall better feel of the thing, apart from these grips which come off. They feel nice when they're all new, but yeah, it's not so great anymore. Still feels good, but it's just, I wish it would, I need to get them glued back on. I need to get it fixed. This controller is good. I like the feel of the texture, but it feels light and plasticky. Like, it's not as bad as the original Xbox One controller, though. I do feel that the new Series X controller is better built. I can twist it and there's no flex. Whereas if I grab my original Xbox One controller, well, there it is, I can creak it around a bit. Can you hear that? Whereas I'm twisting. Oh, they're pretty hard. Yeah. Nothing. So, and same with the Elite. Actually, the Elite, it's got to be a flex to it more than... Actually, the Elite has more flex to it than this one. So, I wonder how good the Elite Series 2 is. And actually, I wonder if they do come out with an Elite Series 3 that takes the design cues from this control, like the share button and whatnot. That would be cool. There was a problem updating the controller. Was it because I flexed it? have to turn it on. Alright. Try again. Update. Maybe I'll just leave the controller for a sec and let it update. Alright, controller is all updated, so let's go next. I found these settings from your last Xbox, including system preferences and ease of access. You change them later. Want to apply them now? I don't want to completely transition everything over. I kind of want a fresh experience out of this thing. Oh, of course, advertising! Although Xbox Game Pass is actually a good deal. It's actually kind of a big deal. It's actually pretty cool because you do get over 100 games for both console and PC. It does include EA for whoever cares about that. I kind of do because Need for Speed. That's the only EA franchise, and maybe Battlefield whenever that comes out. New Xbox Game Studio games are always released on time as well, and you get 30 days of Disney Plus. Okay, that's not bad. I don't have Game Pass. I don't necessarily want it, to be honest, because I buy all my games physically. It does seem like a good deal. I don't know. It kind of conflicts with me personally, because I'm the type of person to buy all my stuff physically. I buy all my games physically. I prefer it that way because of my internet isn't the fastest connection in the world. It takes forever to download stuff, especially when updates for games do take a long time to download. As well as I just like having a physical collection of games, so I don't want Game Pass, so just no thank you. Let's go! Alright, take me home. Oh, it did import my background. Okay, And the interface is exactly the same as the Xbox One. Control, yeah, okay, controller battery is low. But it feels responsive, like, yeah, this feels more responsive than the Xbox One ever did. So let's have a look at these settings. Oh, I have to reset all of that, okay. So I had my profile on the other side. Alright, well, let's go to settings. A lot of people complain that the user interface is the same as the Xbox One. I don't mind, to be honest, because I like the way the Xbox One interface is. Because it's really just Windows with a 10-foot interface shoved onto it. Let's have a look at TV and display options. See what we can do. So we are only on a 1080p TV. Device control, what's this? Oh yes, that's I think allows the device to control the TV. I don't think this TV supports any of that. This TV is a pretty old TV. This TV is about 6 years old. So, and it was a cheap one when I got it too. So what do we have? So we have 4K TV details. So what is this? So it says TV and resolution. So my TV doesn't support 4K UHD, nor does it support 120Hz. So my TV supports none of it, nothing. My TV supports nothing. That's what happens when you have an old TV, guys. Eventually, I'd probably get a new TV. Something better. Because I don't really have the space for something huge. This is only a 32. I don't have the space for something gigantic, like really anything bigger than like a 40. I don't really have space for, so hopefully I can find a decent 4K HDR TV that's in a smaller size. Because everything I see is fairly large. And I don't have the room for that. Yeah, it doesn't support 120Hz at all. Does not support HDR, and watching movies, I do not support Diddly Squat, and capturing games, yeah, so I don't support 4K HDR or 120Hz, so basically I don't support anything the Series X can run. Advanced video modes, so we can do, allow 50Hz, because I'm in a PAL region, I suppose. Yeah, auto HDR, yeah, this TV doesn't support any of that. Oh, can we finally adjust overscan in the fucking menu now? Overrides, DVI, HDMI. Yeah, I do want to override, because my TV's overscan sucks. Use manual settings. Alright. Let's see if this can actually do anything for me. Oh, wow, okay, that's like... What the fuck resolution are we running at? Let's not try this. Okay, so now it's acting as DVI. Okay, what the fuck? Video fidelity, why is it so shit? Maybe I shouldn't override the TV settings. Yep, PC RGB. Yeah, no, it probably doesn't. Honestly, this TV was a cheap one when it was new, and it doesn't really support anything. And now it's back 6 years ago or whatever. I'm just going to go back to automatic. I was just hoping I could adjust the overscan settings because it sucks. Apps can add a border. Yeah, I do prefer that because, yeah, this TV is kind of shit. Yeah, so that's why I want to check out those options. It's basically mirroring my Xbox One because it doesn't have any of the options. So I'm going to go back and let's see if we can... What do we have in My Games and Apps? So this is filtering, so I have everything on my internal... No, there's nothing on external drive. So I've plugged in my external hard drive here. I don't think any of the games will run faster on the external drive because it's a mechanical hard drive. It's a 2 terabyte. It's migrated all... I don't have any apps. They're all on my internal storage. I'm going to have to download those again. Alright, so let's see if we can run Forza because that's a digital game that I have to get a disc out. Run it on the Series X. If this requires an update, not ready yet. But does it require an update? It better not. No, just the Microsoft Store. Is it not ready yet? Yeah. I like the way this D-pad feels on the controller. Do I have to maybe download an update for the Series X, maybe? Yes. Fuck. Damn it. Damn it. I don't want to update. I don't have time. It's going to take forever. How big is it going to be? It wants to update Fortune Island and the Lego thing. How big are these? Yeah, 8 gigabytes. That's going to take me all night. And how much is this one? 6.1 gigabytes. It doesn't sound like much, but that honestly would probably take a good hour or two. And I don't have that because it's already 10 o'clock at night. I've got to go up for work in the morning. I'm probably only going to be up for another couple of hours before I go to bed. Because unlike a lot of people, I actually have a fucking job at the moment. Because I'm grateful I do have a job because of the COVID situation. I'm grateful I do have a job, but still, I have responsibilities. Because when I was back when I did the Xbox One video, I was 18 and fresh out of school. And actually, I did have a job then, but yeah, it was barely part-time and cash in hand, basically. It was a good job, I liked it, but no. Now I have real adulting to do. Yeah, that is the Xbox Series X, so let's actually go ahead and shut it down and see the fast boot time that we have. Let's go power off, turn off. And let's power it off all the way. Okay, let's go for a cold boot and see, now that it's all set up, how fast this thing is. Damn, son. And I think that's because I've got the instant on thing. Turn that off. I'll turn the instant on thing off. Where is it? Let's see. Power mode and startup. I want energy saving. Sorry, no, do not turn off automatically. Because sometimes I believe if it goes into sleep mode while you're downloading, it'll cut off the download. Startup charge. You can actually turn the noises on and off. Yeah, it actually is the same noise as the Xbox One power on, but you just can't hear it as well, because the disk drive makes the same one. So, I'm glad it's real buttons though, I like that. Okay, so let's go back to energy saving, and let's go ahead and turn her off. It is a lot more responsive than the Xbox One, even just scrolling around the UI, you can tell. So that's why I'd love to get a better TV for this thing. Yep, so now that's off, let's go ahead and boot her back up. Yeah, that is quick. That is fast. My Xbox One was so slow to boot up, which would kind of, like, because I've always wanted to use the Xbox One as, like a media device for YouTube or whatever on this bigger screen compared to my computer, but every time I'll do that, I never had it on instant on because of the stupid power brick, and it was just so slow to boot up, and it just never ended up being worth it. So yeah, it doesn't look like it shuts down all the way when you shut it down from here. Turn off console. If I power it back on, it will probably power back on like the hybrid way. Yep, that's off. Turn it back on. Yeah, it just wakes back up from sleep, which is cool, actually. I don't have that stupid power brick to deal with, so I would honestly rather that, because actually what I'm thinking is if I cast, I'm not having it downloaded, but I'm just thinking, if I want to access the big, I might just cast my phone to my Xbox. I can do that, using the YouTube app. I'm wondering if I don't even have to turn the console on first, if I can cast, and then it will tell to go to the Xbox Series X, and then it will just boot up for me and load the YouTube app. Because if you cast from your phone to your Xbox, or I presume PS4 as well, now PS5, I presume if you do that, like, what will happen is, if you have the Xbox at the home, it's going to launch the YouTube app for you. So I'm wondering if it will launch the entire console for me instead, so. Okay, what we're going to try now is we're going to try a disc-based game. To just try the disc drive and see how games play. So we're going to be playing, we'll try Red Dead Redemption 2. It's probably not going to load the fastest. It is going to be running off a mechanical external hard drive, but this is an Xbox One game, so it can do that. So let's put the disc in. Yeah, that drive sounds loud, man. That's louder than the Xbox One drive sucking the disc in. So this one should work, as it only had a 200 meg update to do, so I've downloaded that. That's still quicker than the Xbox One. That usually would take a while. So let's log in. I'm not going to cut any of this part of the video out, as I want to, it's probably, because this is the first time I played it, so it's going to have to sync everything. First time I played it on this console. But I do want to see how fast it loads, even from an external hard drive, so let's load story mode. And see how far we get. I wanted to try Forza, because that was a digital game. And that is one of the ones that is has been updated for the Series X. Although I'm not on a TV enough that can make enough of a difference. But, like, just even the better frame rate, because this game ran kind of poor on the Xbox One. So, the base Xbox One. So, I want to see if just the game will run like it's designed to run on this. And yeah, I know this game's on PC or whatever, but I don't care. I don't have it on PC yet. I probably will buy it, but it's the version I've been playing, was the Xbox version. So yeah, it is loading from a hard drive, so it is probably going to take a while, but I just want to see how it plays. So this is why, if you're going from an Xbox One or One X or whatever to a Series S or Series X, transfer your games to an external hard drive. That way you don't have to re-download them all. But, oh, that's a lot smoother. Let's get off the horse. Yeah, whatever. Yeah, no, this is actually running not bad. Alright, let's get on the horse and I can't shoot in my own place. Right, okay. Okay, let's get out of my place and go to, what gun do I want? That one will do. See if I can find anything to shoot. I keep forgetting in this game you can actually go through the water, rather than the first one you couldn't. I'm saying to shoot, damn it. Now, what did I kill? I killed some kind of animal. Alright, what did we get? Oh, that's not it, that's a rock. It's up here. Oh, I killed two things. Oh, hell yeah, I killed a deer. Alright, let's skin that. Just the frame rate of just me moving around is a lot better. It was so jittery and janky. Honestly, the Xbox One was probably the worst platform to play this game on. Where's my horse? I'm gonna put this in the back of you, boy. Or girl. Actually, my horse is a girl. Apparently, it's the horse it gave me. I haven't sure. I had one that died. And I killed another one, so let's skin that. This game is so pretty. And yeah, this game does look better on the, I mean, I have to turn this lamp off in front of me to really tell the difference, but it looks like it is definitely running at a higher fidelity than the original Xbox One. I'm gonna have to go to somewhere like Saint Denis or wherever to see any details, probably. So I'm gonna go to maybe, let's go to Blackwater. Let's go to Actually, where do I want to go? Let's see. Traveling to Saint Denis is probably going to take it's going to take too long. So, I want to go to Blackwater. Is pretty easy to get to. So, from where I am, right. I don't want to go there. Actually, I might trigger the mission. Let's go to the post office. All right. It does look pretty good so far, and the frame rate's nice. And this is a pretty demanding game for the Xbox One, so... yeah. No, this is great. And, honestly... wait, let's pause the game here. Yeah, there's a little bit of warm air, but... I'm gonna turn my fan off. Yeah, this thing is whisper quiet. It's so quiet, and I'm playing a pretty demanding game. And so apparently you can also do stuff like swapping between two different games. Let's see if I... whoops, not that. You can, like, quick resume. So if I do Forza... oh, I need to update that. I don't want to... how big is the update I need to do for Forza? If it's small, I'll do it. Jesus Christ, no. Alright, let's try Forza Horizon 3, because I know that doesn't need an update. And so, what we're gonna do is, we didn't quit Red Dead Redemption 2. So, this game I do own digitally, so... so I don't have to eject the disc for, Red Dead. But let's play this. Forza Horizon 4 requires a 70 gig update, so we're not gonna run that today. I should skip these. I haven't played this game in a long time, actually. Horizon 3. It even says Xbox One X and... I've never seen that before, because I've never ran it on anything... I mean, I've ran it on a PC. I actually used to play this on PC all the time. But I've never ran it on a One X. Or anything that's like it. Now, this hasn't been optimized for the Series X at all, so this is just a straight-up Xbox One game. Okay, so we have Forza Horizon 3, so it's... I haven't played this in a while. Well, it drives just like Horizon 4. And yeah, controller feels exactly the same when playing stuff like this. Nothing special about it. The rumble feels, yeah, exactly the same, actually. In fact, I think I prefer my Elite controller, to be honest. Turn that off. We could be doing massive skids in Australia, and then go back and play Red Dead 2. And see, it says quick resume in the corner. And there we go. Now we're riding horses back in the old west. And if I want to go back to doing skids, I just go Forza. There we go. Now, I really won't have a use for this feature, to be honest. I tend to only play one game at a time, but I guess if I'm playing something and then the friend's like, bruh, you gotta come play Warzone. Then, yeah, I suppose, but, like, I'd probably just quit the game I was playing already and then just... choose the next one, so... but it's still a cool feature. The fact that this console can do that because of the, you know, the increased memory as well as the SSD. Of course, you can still quit games when you don't want to play them anymore, so let's go back to Red Dead. There we are, this thing is not even breaking a sweat. This thing is gonna be this is pretty cool. I do like it. But there we are, let's just clear Red Dead. There we are, okay. So let me just eject the disc, see how it handles that. Okay, so that wasn't as loud as the inject of the disc. Yeah, it's pretty loud. Take it back out. So that is the Xbox Series X unboxing and just a quick overview here. I think I'm going to like this console. I'm going to have to rearrange my setup a little bit, but this thing is, yeah, pretty cool. Now, I will be getting a PS5, like I said, eventually. I don't, honestly, I've had a PS4, actually. People keep saying on my Xbox One video, well, you should have gotten the PS4. Well, I have a PS4. Do I ever use it? No. I've got a few games for it, but I haven't really played any of them. So I'm probably just going to wait till I get a PS5 and then play through some of those. But generally, Xbox for consoles has been my preferred platform. And so I generally do prefer that, mostly because of the controller, and honestly the online service is a lot better, and Game Pass, even just adding that, has even made it more compelling. Even though I'm not a subscriber of it, it's something that, it's pretty cool to be honest. So there we go, that is the Xbox Series X. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I do have a few more videos to come in the future. I know I haven't been uploading as much lately. But you guys know the drill. My life is pretty busy, especially with my job. Whenever I have stuff to make videos of, I'll try and do it when I can. So, but I do have some stuff coming forward in the coming weeks or whenever I can be, whenever I have time. So, thank you for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.